So today I'm going to be showing you how to do a beach scene on your nails. I just googled a palm tree and this picture came up and I'll put it on the sidebar, so definitely take a look at that. And I just basically copied that onto my nail and this is what I came up with. So I have it on my thumb and I also have it on my ring finger. And then I just painted the rest of my nails just basic blue. I hope you guys enjoyed the tutorial and here it is. Okay, so the first thing we're going to do is apply a cuticle remover. This is the Apple Cuticle Remover from Cuccio. Next, I'm going to apply a nail strengthener by OPI, and then a base coat. This is called Tough Cookie by Orly. So now I'm going to draw the sand right here. Just cut it across this lower corner. And the sand is pretty white. It's kind of like a really, really light tan color. So the closest thing that I have to that light tan color is a pure pearl. And this is from Revlon. And I'm just going to really, really lightly create a little corner over here. And it doesn't have to be absolutely perfect. Even if you get on your skin, that's okay too. We can go ahead and clean that up in a little bit. Okay, so we have that. I'm just going to clean up that excess nail polish that we got on our skin. Okay, so I just dipped my Q-tip into some nail polish remover, and I'm just going to press that onto the skin and remove all of that excess. Now I'm going to apply that really, really pretty turquoisey teal color, and the closest color that I have to that is Caribbean Frost, and this is from Wet n Wild. This is like a dollar at any drugstore, so this is really easy to find. And I'm going to be doing the same thing that I did with the Pure Pearl and just cut that across. But this time I'm going to flatten out that top edge. So right up here I'm just going to make it nice and flat. And then I'm going to kind of dip down into that Pure Pearl, just kind of make it kind of look like water is kind of spilling over onto the sand. Okay, so now I'm going to draw the top part of the water, and this is in dark blue from Art Deco from the LA Colors collection. And you can find this at shopcraze.com. That's where I got this. And these are really nice because they have that nice fine tip brush. So what I'm going to do with that is just move it along right up here, just so we see that really dark horizon, really dark blue. And make it a little bit thicker. So there we have that. Okay, so now we're going to apply the blue for the blue sky, and this is called Shelter Island by Essie, and it's like almost the same color as my background, but it's a super, super pretty sky blue. And you can find this pretty much at any nail salon. I got this from E-Nail Supply along with the cuticle remover and the OPI nail strengthener. So we're just going to continue on with our nail and be really, really careful not to cover up that dark blue that we just placed. Okay, so we're just going to let that set in for a little bit and then we're going to draw some clouds. Okay, so now I'm going to create some clouds like right here near the horizon, and I'm going to mix two colors. This one is from Essie and it's called Sag Harbor, and then I'm going to go back to my Pure Pearl from Revlon, and I'm just going to mix the two together. I'm just going to take a drop of each and just swirl them in with a toothpick and then pick them up with a brush, and the brush that I'm going to be using is this one. And it's just a basic nail brush. And you can buy these at any nail supply store. If you have an old eyeliner brush laying around too, you can use that too. They pretty much do the same thing. So, okay, so I'm gonna mix the colors and we're gonna draw our clouds on. Now the clouds aren't too complex. You just kinda draw random sort of pillowy objects, and there really doesn't have to be any kind of definite shape. Now I'm going to wipe off my brush, and I'm going to dip it into a little bit of nail polish remover, and this is going to help thin out those clouds, just so they're not like real definite shapes. So just thin those out, just so they kind of fade out, and it really kind of helps to blend out those edges as well. Okay, so there we have our clouds. If you want to pick up a little bit more and just thin it out with some nail polish remover, you can go and do that too. So this is with the thinned out nail polish mix that we made with some nail polish remover. So there we go. We have some nice pillowy clouds there. So now we are going to draw our palm tree, and we're going to start off with our trunk, which of course is brown, and the only brown color that I have is called Unplugged, and this is from China Glaze. And again, we're going to be using our nail art brush, so even if you have an old eyeliner brush, go ahead and grab that. So I'm first going to draw a little base right here. Okay, so just draw a little tiny line like that, and then kind of bring it up to a tiny little triangle. And then we're going to start with our trunk. And most palm trees aren't like perfectly straight, so I'm going to kind of curve this out as I go up. So as you can see, it's kind of coming together now. We're almost done, and we are going to draw the branches of the palm tree now. And I'm going to be using something from Migi Art, and this is like those little pens, and this is going to help me to just give a little bit more accurate application for the branches. So I'm just going to draw little squiggly lines out like this. I'm just going to draw a bunch of them too. Really want my palm tree to be nice and thick and really full. Okay, so we have that. Now I'm going to add a little bit of contouring to that, and I'm going to be using a dark green, and this is called Emerald City from Sally Hansen. Oh, and if you're curious about these Migi nail art pens, I got this from shopcraze.com, and they have like a ton of colors, so you might want to check them out there if you aren't interested. They do make the application a little bit easier. So now I'm going to take that dark green color and just do a lot of contouring to our palm tree. This is going to darken everything up and just add a lot of shadows and make the tree look a little bit more realistic, because it kind of just looks like a blob right now. So we're just going to add our shadows here and there, but really just add a lot of dimension and fullness to our palm tree. Okay, so we're almost done. We have one last step, and this is completely optional, but I'm just going to add a little bit of highlighting to our palm tree. And I'm going to use a bright, bright yellow color. This is called Celtic Sun, and it is from China Glaze. So I picked up a little bit of that Celtic Sun onto my brush, and we're just going to very, very lightly draw that here, especially like toward the middle, and just kind of bring it out a little bit. That's going to darken up any areas, but it's also going to add dimension, like with the dark green, the medium green, and then the yellow. You'll notice like at the front of the tree, there's like a nice yellow ribbing sort of going on. So there we go. We have a nice dimensional sort of palm tree. And then we're going to wait a few minutes just to kind of wait for all the nail polishes to set in, and then we're going to apply our top coat, and I'll show you which top coat I really, really recommend. Okay, so the top coat that I recommend is Seche Vite, and you can get this at pretty much any nail supply store. I got this at Sally Beauty Supply Store, so I think it's really good. It dries like within 5 minutes, so it's really, really good for nails, especially when you have little designs going on and you don't want to mess it up and you want your nail polish to dry right away. So anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed this. I hope you have a fabulous, fabulous summer. And if you ever get to go and visit a place just like that picture, let me know how it's like, because I can only imagine how gorgeous it is. So you guys have a fabulous summer. And I hope you guys enjoyed this nail tutorial. And I'll see you guys next time. Bye.